I'm going to show you how to use the Ronald Koeman formation, a 4-2-3-1 formation, which is position based. Let's go. The notification shoutouts for today are from Arya Sarkar and Mysterious Gaming. If you want a shoutout, just turn that post notification button on and be the first to comment under my new videos. Ronald Koeman, you know that he's a former Netherlands player and he's also the Netherlands national coach as well as the current Barcelona manager. Well, I actually don't know if seeing that he's Barcelona's manager now, he has to like resign from being Netherlands coach. I guess we'll find out more about that in the future. So, as you guys may know, it's a 4-2-3-1 formation and it's position based. If you look right here, you guys can see that this team strength isn't really that strong. So, to basically use this manager, I basically have to put like a base black ball into the side, which is Varane, because my feature players and legend players are too strong for the team. If you look at his information right here, it's a 4-2-3-1, both offensive and defensive. Simple 1-2. Position based ball game, short pass wide, flexible front line pressure, wide and aggressive. That is for both attack and defense. So basically, as you can see right here, is that basically it's just a soul striker up top. With that soul striker, there are a lot of advantages and disadvantages. So I'm about to list out the advantages as well as the disadvantages, because I want you guys to understand that there are no perfect formations. So I'm going to tell you guys, or give you guys, reasons as to why you should use this formation or why you shouldn't. So let's get into that right now. The first advantage is that it's a position-based formation, so you get to keep the ball longer. And seeing that he's the Barcelona manager, you know that there's tiki-taka in this formation. So it helps you to keep the ball longer, as well as break down defenses easier. And if you break down defenses easier, then you know you have a lot of opportunities in the game to shoot. And usually, it's not really the case that who has more possession wins the game. But if you have more possession, that means you're creating more chances for you to take shots. So all you have to do is just don't waste your shots. This formation is very good defensively. As you can see, I have a Fofaleo right here with actually three center backs and a wing back. Usually, I would use two wing backs, but what I've realized is that this formation is actually susceptible to pass and goals through the center. And sometimes it's because the wing backs are a bit too high up. I revert to using three center backs instead of two, and that has helped me to actually cover for more defensive errors that usually happen. Another advantage is that my wing backs play a key role in going forward and crossing the ball. They play a very integral role in getting the ball up forward, because mostly your attack actually has to come through the wings, because the lone striker up top cannot do it by himself, and the attacking mid forward is actually working as a creative playmaker. And as a creative playmaker, you're going to play a little bit deep so you can send the ball forward. And if you're sending the ball forward to one striker who has taken three defenders, it doesn't make any sense. But you put it on the wing, where you have the wing back and the winger, which in this case is probably going to be Roberto Carlos and Neymar. So that's 2-3. That's better odds than 1-3, if you get what I'm trying to say. Disadvantages now, the team strength is only 830, as I said earlier. You can literally only attack down wings, as I just explained, and sometimes with just going down the wings is going to become very predictable, because once you know you score a one goal or a two goal, the opponent starts realizing, oh, all the attacks are coming from the wing, so let me just, you know, shield off the wing, and then it forces you to go center. When you go center, there are no options for you there, so you end up not scoring any goals. And it's also susceptible to counter attacks, so you have to make use of every opportunity. So you see, if you're controlling the game and you're making a lot of passes but you're not taking any shots, the moment that you lose the ball, especially in an uncomfortable position and concede, it's going to be very hard for you to really come back and say, oh, let me try to score. So yeah, that's also a problem. All right, so y'all already know the drill. I'm just going to play it out so you guys can see quick. I just want you guys to see it first, and then I'm going to explain my actions towards it. This is basically just a simple breakdown of like an in-game build-up play, basically, towards scoring with him. So basically what you guys can see is that, as I was saying earlier before, this formation is... This formation is very, it's very defensively good. And seeing that I have my three players right here, you have a player running right here. You see, if this player gets the ball, as you can see here, and this player is going to run past, because I don't know why my wing backs keep, you know, they're just staring. If this player can turn and get a good cross or a good pass in, then that's going to be a problem for me. So luckily I got the ball, defended it well. Carlos came to the, you know, rescue. So now he's out there. He has to clear the ball, because sometimes I don't believe from really playing that far from the back, especially if you see a clear pass right there. I was actually aiming for, I think it was him, but he ran to Beckham, so it still worked in my favor. I saw Lukaku up front. Keep in mind, I said earlier that the lone striker up front, he can't really do much. Even if you're the best dribbler in the world, it's still going to be very hard for you to surpass three defenders. So the best thing to do is pass it off to your wingers. So your striker basically acts as a distributor for your wingers. But the thing is, your striker is going to basically come in some of the defenders for you to be able to, you know, get through and surpass that line of defense. So your winger can go on to score the goal. That's what I say, you need good wingers who can actually cross as well as take shots. So as you can see here, Lukaku is about to get the ball because Scholes intercepts. Lukaku gets the ball. Look at Rashford making the run right there. You notice that you have Diego Carlos, the lone defender right here coming in. I can't just surpass by that, because then this defender will approach me, and then if I go this way, this defender will approach me. So the best thing to do is hold up play for a while. So I hold up the play for a while. Lukaku is there. I see Rashford making the run, so I time it perfectly. Look at the run. Look at this easy run. The guy on online didn't even know what he did. Look at the run. So he makes the run now. Rashford is there. Rashford is clear. Everything is good. And Rashford takes a shot and he scores. It's just as simple as that, guys. Just as simple as that. So that's just the example of me showing you guys how overlapping wingers can be really, really good. So basically, I'm just going to outline the type of players that I use in my side to basically show you guys, you know, how to set up your side. So firstly, I use a defensive goalkeeper. I'm using Taldo, mainly because, you know, he's a keeper that's going to be removed and he's a defensive goalkeeper. Other defensive goalkeepers are more like Handanovic and I think probably Oblak. So you guys can use them. I use a defensive goalkeeper so he can stay on his line more often, because in this formation that I have three center backs around the back. So nobody will just get past the defense like that, because I've actually stopped a lot of long ball spamming. And even if the ball passes them, I don't want the goalkeeper to charge out, because then you'll be chipped easily. It's better you stay on his line and defend, because by the time that ball come over, it's more than likely in the box. So, you know, the keeper doesn't have to move out unless he has to. As I said, I only use one wing back. So what I do is that on my subs, I have Cafu. So let's say Roberto Carlos is off form, which I don't think he can because he's an iconic moment player. But let's just say that he's off form, or Cafu is on green and Roberto Carlos is on regular. I can just switch out Cafu and put him over here where Beckham ball is, and put Beckham ball here, and then just switch out the positions and then the usual. Put Beckham ball as a center forward and put Cafu as right back into his main position. Just as simple as that. That's why I changed up my defenders now. My defenders can be anything. I'm using two build up play players. The thing is, you can use any combination of defenders that you want to use. I preferably use a build up play player in it. As long as you have a build up play in there, you're good. So right here you can see that you just need some good players that can defend good, have the interception trait, and have good heading. So this is Bastoni. Bastoni is pretty good. His heading is really good. He even has the heading trait. He doesn't have the interception trait, but he's a destroyer. So that kind of covers for him. And his defensive stats aren't that bad. He has 99 heading, you know. His physical contact is really good, and his defensive awareness is really, really good. So that's a plus. My midfield now, I use a defensive mid, a center mid, and an attacking mid forward. So for defensive mid, my defensive mid forward is going to be Vera. Vera is a destroyer, so I use him there. For the center mid, I use Paul Scholes and Orchestrator. This is to help in the attack. Paul Scholes has really, really good skills and really, really good stats. So he can be used to go on to my wingers. So for right mid forward and left wing forward, he actually should be using some wingers, because you need some presence who can cut in and score as well as pass. I use Beckham because he's a crossing merchant. And I mean, once you cross, the more than likely he's going to go to the player. So you just need a good player up front who can head the ball properly. So in attacking midfield, you need a whole player. A whole player being Bruno Fernandes, you know. Mainly because you need somebody who can run into space so that they can help the striker up top, because sometimes he's, you know, a bit lonely. But at least if he's creating an opportunity for the attacking midfield to run past the defender, then he will take it. So you guys can use Bruno Fernandes as well. He's really, really good in every single aspect of the game. He's one of the best cams in the game, so you can use him. The striker, you just need a fast striker with good heading. I prefer using Immobile, but you guys can use Morientes, Lukaku, Aubameyang, any other strikers that have good heading and good finishing. You can just use that. So all in all, it's a decent formation. I probably won't be using this as my main formation, but at the same time, it's a very good formation. Don't forget to smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, go to 10,000 subscribers. The comment keyword for today is sports. So just comment down below sports so I can know that you reach this part of the video. Well,